الرحمن الرحيم ربي يسر ولا تعسر وتمنن بالخير ربي زدني علما السلام عليكم students how are you all I hope all of you are in good health and iman students welcome to the online classes today we are going to start our lecture number 9 in which we will complete our remaining lesson number 11 so grab your books and let's start our last part of tenses which is present and past perfect tense our objectives are definitions formations drill and most important translation so let's start with the present perfect tense so present perfect tense is the last type of the present tense among three tenses So let's start with the examples. We have done our job. हम अपना काम कर चुके हैं. She has not forgotten her folder. वो अपने folder को नहीं भूली है. Have you accepted your mistake? क्या आपने अपनी गलती कबूल कर ली है? Now notice the last two words. of the Urdu translation चुके हैं भूली है कर ली है You may have noticed that there are two possibilities चुके हैं भूली है कर ली है भूल चुके हैं या कर चुके हैं Okay but here you will put भूली है कर ली है due to the composition of the sentence so here are two possibilities through which you can guess or judge that which kind of tense you will use in the english translation of these urdu sentences kar chuke hain bhuli hai kar li hai okay now look at the second example wo apne folder ko nahi bhuli hai now read with me without hai वो अपने फोल्डर को नहीं भूली इफ़ वी डोंट रीड है विद भूली दिस होल सेंटेंस विल बिकम ऑफ सिंपल पास्ट विच शोज दैट एक्शन इन दिस सेंटेंस हैज़ डन इन द पास्ट बट व्हेन वी पुट है आफ्टर दिस व्हेन वी पुट है आफ्टर द एक्शन दिस विल प्रूव दैट This action has happened in the past, but not a distant past. It happened in the recent past. So, those actions that happened in the recent past are the present perfect. We will use for them present perfect tenses. How we can use? We have done our job. You will see there are two verbs. One will be the helping verb. And the other is the main verb. Next, she has not forgotten her folder. Here, we have put not between helping verb and the main verb, which is in its third form. Have you accepted your mistake? This is the interrogative. So we started the English sentence with the helping verb. Okay, you will see that some have have and some have has okay some in some sentences there is have and in some sentences there is has why due to the situation of the subject when there is a plural subject we will put have as a helping verb we is the plural subject next she is the singular subject so we will put has as the helping verb And next, you is the personal pronoun, so we will put have as the helping verb. Okay, now move to the breakdown of one example. Through its breakdown, we will extract definition and formation. So here is the example. We have done our job. हम अपना काम कर चुके हैं. Look at the last two words. चुके हैं. This action has happened, but this action have completed in near past. So those for those actions or those work which have happened in the near past, we don't use for them simple past. We use present perfect for them. Here, we is the subject, have is the helping verb, done is the past participle of do, which is third form of verb, and our job will be the object of the sentence. Now, from this, we can extract the definition, which will be, it shows the action or work that has happened in near past. Okay, so what are the situations of the subject? For personal pronoun and plural subjects, we use have as the helping verb. And for the singular subject, we use has as the helping verb. Now we will analyze three types of sentences one by one. Simple sentence, negative sentence, and interrogative one. And their formations also. For simple sentence, there is the example, we have done our job. Hum apna kaam kar chuke hain. Here, we is the subject. Have is the helping verb. Done is the third form of verb. And our job is the object. This is the formation of simple sentence. Now, moving to the simple negative sentence. The example is, she has not forgotten her folder. Wo apne folder ko nahi bhuli hai. Here, she is the subject. Then, has will be the helping verb. Then, you will put in negative sentence, not after has, after helping verb. And then, there will be the third form of verb. Very good. And last, object. Very good. So, this is the formation of the simple negative sentence. Come to the simple interrogative sentence. Have you accepted your mistake? Kya aapne apni galti kabool kar li hai? In interrogative sentences, we start the sentence with the yes, with the helping verb. Then we will put subject. Then it is third form of verb. And in the last, it is a object. Very good. Now, see the formation thoroughly. Subject plus helping verb has have according to situation of the subject. Third form of verb plus object. In negative, subject plus helping verb plus not plus third form of verb plus object. Interrogative, helping verb plus subject plus third form of verb plus object. So this is the present perfect tense.